Okay. So we'll start discussion on rating scales. I'll just present a few things before then we'll move on. Okay. So basically, what I want to discuss is psychiatric rating scales. We have, you know, basic concepts that we will talk about. You know those concepts, but we don't use them when we employ rating scales. Okay, so rating scales, you know, we use for what? Their questionnaires, interviews, okay, checklists, and we use them for making a diagnosis. And in research, in cases, you use rating scales, even in some psych administration, like for treatment questionnaires, or sorry, satisfaction questionnaires are there. So that all are used. Okay, but the basic thing is that. And also basically where diagnosis ke liye use karte, okay, and we use it for measuring the severity, all right, screening some conditions like CAGE questionnaires, their general functioning questionnaires, and then their overall outcome. But how do you choose a rating scale? If there is one condition, there will be number of rating scales for that. So which rating scales to use for which procedures? So basically for that purpose, we are having this discussion. Okay. So there are four basic things that, sorry, I want to talk about: sensitivity, specificity, reliability, and validity. These are must know concepts. Okay. All of you in all, like not only in psychiatry, but everywhere where you go, and you will be doing research. If you will be doing MD, you'll be doing thesis. So you should know what are these four concepts properly so that you can do the research properly. Okay. So this is a chart which I think all of you would have seen in community medicine. Okay. So this suppose is the ABCD is the total population. All right. And A plus C is the disease population. Out of those total populations, these are the diseased patients. And these are ones who don't have the disease. All right. So what I do is I use a test. Okay. And it's just identify some patients as a condition. For example, I want to identify diabetes. All right. And I have a test that can identify from blood sugar above 100. Okay. And I use this test to screen patients. From that, I get a number of patients as positive. All right. And the other C who have a disease, but the test does not catch it. So that is C. Okay. Then similarly, the tests which are not having disease, so it finds that A, it says that are positive, B, it says are negative. Okay. But the total test, this is the one. All right. A plus B is what it says are positive. Out of it, B are, they are. They're not having disease, but the test still says incorrectly that they have this condition. These are called false positive. Okay, you should get the choice or something. Okay, and these are the patients who have the disease, but the test says that the test is unable to find. So these are false negative. Okay, and these the test has correctly identified. All right, so what is sensitivity and what is specificity that we need to
clear? So, sensitivity is the ability of the test to find the true positives. Okay, this one, this population.
So, out of the total patients that have disease, what is the test ability to identify? A higher fraction. We would like it to be 100%. We would like that A should be equal to this. C should be 0. That is the ideal condition that we would want. Okay, and we would want that this B should be 0 and D should be equal to the total disease. Like it is able to identify all the disease patients and it is not identifying any person who is not having a disease as positive. All right. So it
sensitivity is A over A plus C, the number of diseased patients that the test has correctly identified. Okay, from the total diseased patient. Okay, you see it has, then you see that it has got nothing to do with the false positives. For example, if there is a population and the test identifies from there are all the patients are positive. Incorrectly also, jo negative one goes to positive curve. That test sensitivity will be 100%. Okay, so just increasing sensitivity is not right. We require specificity also. Okay, so as we move forward, what is specificity? So specificity, on the other hand, is say the capacity of the test to identify the disease. All right. So this population, the true patients who don't have a disorder and they are found negative. All right. So we want this to be bigger, this to be smaller. Okay. So that is specificity. If you use a specific test and it rules out disorder, then there is a high chance that the patient does not have it. Okay. Again, it has got nothing to do with positives. If a test is highly specific, it identifies correctly all the patients who don't have disease, but it gives you lots of false positives. That test will also have a 100% specificity. Okay. So alone sensitivity or specificity of a test is not sufficient to choose. So let's take this example. For example, we have a population where there are 100 are disease patient and 100 are disease free. And I employ the test. Okay. And from the test, it is found that 90 patients were positive and 110 were negative. Okay. Now, what is the validity sensitivity of this test? How do we find what is the sensitivity or what is the specificity? We don't have data. Okay. Just by using a test, ek patient liya humne, usko depression ne hamti lagaya, dekha usme depression hai ki nahi hai, aur divide kar diya ki positive negative, we cannot measure the sensitivity and specificity. All right, we will need a test, gold standard, use that. Okay, and then from that find out these are the patients. So this, we use a test. For example, the scenario I was talking about, that I have a test that identifies more than 150 blood sugar. Okay. After that, if 90 are positive, 110 are negative, then I do their fasting blood sugar in this, all the patients to see how my test is doing. And then I get this data that actually 80 are having the disorder, 20 are not having, 20 are negative. This is the scenario from the diseased patients. Now I can find out what is the sensitivity. It is 80%, because out of 100 patients, it has correctly identified 80. Okay, we can calculate this also then, that 10 were actually say positive, the test screened them positive, but they did not have the disease. So this is false positive. And this again, they are screened negative. All right, but they had the disease. So this is the false negative. Okay. So this is what it is there. Okay. So here for this test, the sensitivity is 80% and specificity is 90%. All right. Let's move to a scenario where I say that, okay, this is not a good condition. I want to increase the sensitivity. Okay. 80 patients it is identified. I want more population, larger population. So I say that, okay, this test is now going to identify patients who are like, tweak the test, 130 ke upar they identify. Okay. So it will identify more patients. Okay. So this will identify 99 patients. Pehle 90 kar raha, 99 kar liya. Ye negative will decrease. Okay. But the thing is that when you tweak any test to increase its ability to catch patients, it will not specifically increase this only screen positive. It will increase the total positive patients. That is the thing, that if you equate test, if you make it in such a way that it is able to catch a larger population, So it can't differentiate, like specifically act only on population. Aapko to pata nahi before the test, who is having the disorder and who is not having the disorder. You can only make the test more sensitive. Okay. And so what will happen is that actually, so out of 99, 88 will only increase. It's not like that it will increase from 80 to 90. And there will be increment in one false positive case. From 10 to it will become 11. Okay. So my sensitivity by increasing the test, tuning it up for 10%, it has increased by 10%. From 80, it has gone to 88. But this has decreased from 90 to 89. Okay. Because I have made my test in such a manner now that it is catching more patients, but it will be catching false positives also. Okay. So there is an inverse relationship between sensitivity and specificity. Similarly, if I say, no, this, I don't want any, like if the alternate scenario, I want that only diabetic patients should be called. So I tweak my test, only patients above 200 will be called. So a lot of patients who are having a disorder will go away, get away. They will be false negative. Okay. So in that case, the sensitivity will decrease. So if I have one given one test, if I tweak it, so the sensitivity and specificity have an inverse relationship. So I want to keep the limits in such a manner that my sensitivity is also okay and my specificity is also there. All right. So that is the scenario. Let's just talk about this later. So tests with high sensitivity, they will be good for screening because they will include all the patients. So jo aapka bach gaya, jo positive population hai, you work more on that and you try to find out what are false negatives. Usme koi incorrectly be identified honge, then you work it further. All right. And specific tests are good for ruling out. Okay. For example, you do CPK for a patient who's having MS. Okay. If it is negative, it is not there. It rules out sort of MS, but it does not say give you the diagnosis. All right. In a patient where there is CPK is high, it does not diagnose MS also. So because it can give you a lot of false positive also. So you have to identify key or care reasons also. So that is a test that has a good specificity, but the sensitivity in the sense that like it can give false positive also. So I have to work further. Okay. So a combination of tests is better. You use a sensitive test to catch and then you use a specific test for. So in that scenario, using two tests is better. All right. Okay. So let's now come to reliability. All right. What is reliability? Can anybody tell? Students, you must have learned in community medicine. No, it's repeatability basically. Consistency. Okay. Like repeatability. So it is like the overall consistency of a measure. Okay. It gives the same reading. So you have a BP instrument, you take the blood pressure. It gives you the same measurement. So Ishani does, it gives the same measurement. You do it after 5 minutes, 10 minutes. So there is a good variability. It is consistent. But if you check it with other instrument, it gives you wrong reading. Okay. So consistency of the measure is called reliable. Like it should be giving similar reading in the same patient in the similar condition. And so it should not vary. All right. So basically there are, say, the findings of the instruments are replicated. You apply it, anybody applies it, the change is not that much. All right. If there is a lot of fluctuation, like one day the PP machine is giving 90-100, the same machine is giving after some time, it is giving 120, 80. So that is not right. All right. So that is that it is reliability issue. All right. There is internal consistency. Ye aapko batana chahiye that you'll find Cronbach alpha. So what happens is that how do we define, make instruments? We want that the instruments, whatever there are, the items there are in the instruments or rating scale, they should move together. Alag bhi honi chahiye aur ek jaise bhi honi chahiye. For example, I want to devise a rating scale for depression. All right. And I put hopelessness, sadness, sleep, appetite, grooming, social interaction, okay, things like that. And then for 100, 200 patients, I do a rating and I find how the rating is going. And on analysis, I find that, okay, so with depression, the appetite is also decreasing or increasing, the sleep is varying, but the grooming somehow is moving independently, or the social interaction action is independent, moving independently. Like in severe patients also, sometimes grooming is good. Okay, and in say moderate patients also, sometimes grooming is very bad. Okay, so there are factors that are independent of depression that are affecting it. So I will remove that item from the depression rating scale. Okay, this is how actually all the rating scales have been devised. Man's item, for example, it has 30 items. So they started with the number of symptoms, 100, and then they analyzed it, and then they found that which were the items that were actually moving with the disorder. So most of the standardized rating scales that you have, so they have not, you know, woken up and said ki ye item hone chahiye. So they have analyzed, like, these things they are moving with the depression, other things they are not so much affected. All right, so that is why that standardized, well, their validity, their reliability. So you can't divide. So this, why this is important, that many times I see from the nursing, they have sometimes too, there is a habit, I think there is a culture for doing a thesis where they will devise a new instrument and they will test its validity. So wo char rating scale mein se yahan se do question, yahan se do question utha ke ye mera rating scale ho gaya sir, aap isko validate kar lijiye. So this is not how it works. Okay, you can't take two questions from HAMD, two questions from hospital anxiety scale, two questions from say HAM anxiety, and then combine it and say that I have a new rating scale. Okay, so these items in the said condition should move together. So that is Cronbach alpha. Okay, there is external consistency where there is test retest. Like if you test one patient, so it should give similar findings 1 hour, 2 hour later on. Okay, or inter-rater, like if two raters they are testing, they are applying that criteria, then it should have similar, same or similar. Okay, very good question. We'll use that for discussion. Okay. So validity, okay, reliability is a basically easier term to establish. It should have consistent results. Difficult to understand is validity. What is validity? Validity is what I think Dr. Adhiki said. Like, it should correctly measure what it is supposed to measure. All right. Okay. So test appears to measure what it is supposed to measure. If I'm using, say, HAMD, it should be measuring depression. It should not be measuring uncooperativeness. Okay, if in uncooperativeness it is regularly giving higher, or it is moving with that, so that is the main. All right. So in other places it is easier. For example, I devise a, say, instrument to measure the pulse. Band laga diya, pulse jaise ye aajkal hai, pulse measure kar raha hai. Aur kaise karoge, but it is whether it is valid or not. How do you do it? You use it. You stethoscope se laga ke dekhte ki jo pulse ya pulse measure karke dekhenge. How, whether it is actually measuring what it is supposed to measure. It is not measuring skin conductance. It is not measuring oxygen saturation. Okay, oximeters also give you a pulse rate, but the validity of that is not very good. Why? Because wo oxygen, jo oxygenated blood ki pulse aati hai, usko wo measure karta hai. Aur do jo pulse hain, unko wo read karke, unko unke hisab se wo it finds out the rate. It can vary very quickly, but we know that we measure the pulse rate for 1 minute, and that is the heart rate. So it can be like in, say, in disorders where there is arrhythmia, the pulse rate can vary. All right, no? So what we see is that the result should of the instrument should correlate with the gold standard. Okay, for example, I do an X-ray. What X-ray say? They diagnose tuberculosis. What is the gold standard? The gold standard is getting the AFP. Okay, so they find out that whether that is, so जो है वो उसमें दिख रहा है कि नहीं दिख रहा है. Okay, उसमें अगर positive आता है तो यहाँ पे वो दिखता है कि नहीं दिखता है. All right.
Now, the thing is that
more or less.
Thank you. So what one thing more that you will find in now this part, I think for this part it is easier. Validity is one thing that in psychiatry, whenever validity comes, there are question marks, and we'll talk about this later, like in the next slide. So, but validity concept you understand, like it is like if you have a weighing machine, it is actually measuring the weight. All right. Or if you have say any test, though, it is identifying the thing that you want to identify. For example, we are using glycosylated hemoglobin, okay, for diabetes. It is also dependent upon hemoglobin. So patients who have anemia, okay, severe anemia, they may not give you correct result. We are indirectly trying to correlate. Okay. So, but it does reflect a blood sugar, so that we know. Okay, so each limitation, there are limitations of each test, right? But the validity is that it is appearing to measure what you are trying to measure. You use HAM-D and you measure, apply it in schizophrenia patients. You will get reliable results. Okay, HAM-D, if you apply it in patient of schizophrenia, there is also anhedonia, mood, so you will get reliable results. And they may also vary with the treatment because negative symptoms will vary. But that does not mean that our test is valid, because it is not tuned to measure psychosis. All right. So validity is like it is measuring what it's supposed to measure. Right. So let's come to an important concept is construct. Okay. You will read in reading skill. Constructs. What is construct? So construct is, say, it is an abstract idea, underlying theme or subject matter that we wish to identify. Okay. We have now. So next thing is also important that it is not a direct observation of nature. Heart rate you measure directly. Okay. For example, if I have a test, ultrasound, I am measuring the size of liver. Okay. I can very easily say measure size of liver in cadaver. And then after autopsy, measure the size of liver and correlate those days to find. That is the gold standard. And see how my instrument is doing in comparison to the gold standard. So I have a concrete objective thing that is there. In angiography, I can do autopsy again, find out whether the vessel is occluded or not, which was there in angiography. What do we do in psychiatry? Okay, you have rating from HAM-D. Okay, where do you, what do we measure? Concrete, direct observation from nature. So this is a, say, limitation of all the, you can say, sciences, not only psychiatry, but wherever behavior or society factors are concerned. So we construct an we have a construct. We define a construct. What is construct? Construct is something, an abstract idea. And what we are studying are constructs. Perception, okay, thinking, attention, concentration. These are all constructs. We have defined them properly. And these have been established after some, you can say, research, not that somebody comes up with something and we start identifying that. But these are basically constructs. Okay. So these are abstract ideas. And we are trying to measure those abstract ideas in a manner that it is reliable. Okay. So the problem is that how do we define the construct? Okay. Again, if we have one construct, so we can define into, for example, cognition. So you see in DSM also for cognition, they have again given domains. Okay. In psychosis also, we have domains, positive symptoms, negative symptoms, cognitive symptoms. So one abstract can be divided into domains also. Okay. So each domain also we can define. So these are the basic ideas that we study. And what are the constructs? For example, diagnosis. This is a construct. We all have decided that it is like schizophrenia. We cannot, with an autopsy, that is actually functional and organic came into being. We cannot on autopsy show that this disorder is schizophrenia. This is having depression. We can't do so something in brain, concrete direct observation of nature that this disorder exists. Okay. So diagnosis, sign, symptoms, severity, functional impairment, quality of life, these are all constructs. Okay. And this is what we are studying. So
question comes about validity. So the validity of the instrument is limited by the validity of the construct. सबसे पहले तो आपको ये कहना है कि मैं study क्या कर रहा हूँ. Diagnosis is a different construct. Severity is a different construct. So you can't use an instrument that is made to study the severity of a disorder for diagnosis. Okay, many times people are doing it. Ki Hamdisham depression diagnose kar rahe. Okay, so this is not right because the instrument is made to for one thing. It is like using a tape or using a height to measure weight. Hoga height ke sath weight bhi karta hai alter. Jiski jitni zyada height hogi uska utna zyada weight hoga. Ek correlation to hai, but it is not accurate. Okay. So there are a number of things in validity that we will study about psychiatry. I'll just give you a few things. Okay, face validity and content validity. Face validity is like on the face it is appearing that you are measuring the right thing. Okay, depression, whether it depends how, whether you're, so these things, it is appear straight from the question that okay, face validity is it? Yes, that thing will correlate with it. Okay, where they you will not find face validity. So ho sakta hai. Personality questionnaires, they can, it is not clear what we are measuring. So many times it is there that we are indirectly trying to measure personality questionnaires for malingering. Okay, there are questionnaires. So for substance abuse, there are questionnaires there. We indirectly try to find motivation, insight again. So there are domains construct where from the face it is not obvious what you are doing. Okay. Then criteria validity. Criteria validity is like a, you can say validity in other areas. Lead ek tumhari textbook mein likha hai Kaplan mein, that is longitudinal expert evaluation and all data. So for example, diagnosis. I make an instrument and from that I diagnose schizophrenia. So I do a longitudinal assessment. Over the time, yes, the diagnosis sticks. Okay. And the experts evaluate. And they use all data, not only while interview, but also from the caregiver, from the hospital staff. And they use that to make a holistic, you can say, a big picture. And from that, they do an assessment. Okay. So that they will take as gold standard. And basically, ye to, matlab, hai kya hai? Agar, dekho to ye, it is history taking and clinical evaluation. Comprehensive history taking and clinical evaluation is still the gold standard for diagnosis. Okay, so you use any diagnostic interview, so that is to be matched with that. Okay, content validity is basically a balanced coverage of the construct. Okay, so you have a construct, for example, depression. You see that what are the symptoms, sleep, appetite, anhedonia, etc. So you see that the rating scale has all these features. Okay, there is one example given, I think, for content validity in your textbook regarding it being measured with external validators like main bipolar ke liye lithium or jo hai episode. I think that's not a correct example to use actually. Okay. But it is like it should have all the contents. What I think the phrasing that sentence, they have lost the meaning. It is like if you are making a scale to diagnose bipolar disorder. So we know that the constructs of bipolar disorder are that it is episodic, it responds to lithium, and it has the family history. So we should include these things also in the whatever rating scale that we are using. Okay, so that is the content validity. Discriminant validity, that is like they should be able to discriminate between two populations. So if I devise a scale, that is the main thing. Hamilton, like patients who are in remission, who are still depressed, okay, having disorder, not having disorder. And also, like if you use criteria, then the two criteria should be separate. Okay, for example, in the rating scale, it is not like you are measuring one thing in different, okay, aapke points jo hai alag alag bhi move karne chahiye, right? And it should be sensitive to change. Okay, so if you have an intervention or there is a worsening of disorder, then your instrument should show that change. If somebody goes into remission, your instrument should show that change. So these are the things that should be there in the validity. So validity is basically a little confusing stuff, so that you should know. But you should know that each instrument is meant to measure a specific, you can say, scenario, locations. For example, pants jo hai aapko 7 days ka deta hai. Agar aapne aaj subah pants lagaya, sham ko pants lagaya, bahut different nahi aayega usko. because it measures for the past 7 days. Similar biomarker as HAMD. Okay, that is there. So discussion. Let's start. I think I have questions. Number one. So let's start with this. What about, say you want to screen patients in OPD? What kind of questionnaire would you, what kind of instrument would you want like? High sensitivity. Okay, so we use an instrument that is a very high sensitivity. Okay, apart from that, additional things. So ye inhi ko leke nahi aur bhi to rating scales ke criteria hote hain aur kya hona chahiye usme agar aapko. Okay, comprehensible, easy to understand. Okay, very good. So it should be less time taking. It should be easy to understand. Comprehensible. It should have ease of use. So I can't use 15 minutes assessments for all if I am intending to screen all the patients. So two or three questions, but these questions should be good enough to screen patients, and they can I can find right further. For example, if you have PHQ-2 or 3 questions for depression, you screen them and then you validate further. So you have 100 patients out of 100, you can screen 20. Okay. So good screening questionnaires are required for taking patients for a thesis. For example, if you're taking, so it is better that you start off with a short 2 to 5 minutes instruments which screen patients and you include those patients only. Okay. This question. Can we use one item of a rating scale separately? There is a Beck's hopeless scale. It's too big. I will use hopelessness from HAMD, or maybe I will use, say, depression. HAMD is too big. I will use depression from PANSS. Can I use depression from PANSS to this? No. What is the problem? That is where the things that we discussed come to. What is the problem? Why can't I use it? It is validated, so why can't I use it? Construct. Okay. What construct that instrument is basically measuring. Okay. You have a weighing scale. Okay. So, utha ke le jao sabji wale ke paas ki hum to isi se ab sabji kharidenge. Hai na? It will not show the right result because it is meant to, like, it will not 1 kg, 2 kg, it may not show the same validity with the instrument that is meant to measure. So, each measuring scale also has a range. So it will measure from 1 kg to 5 kg. This will measure from 40 to 80, or similarly, things like that. Okay. So you can't use one thing to measure other. Okay. But there is a rider, like there is a criteria validity. Okay. So many instruments have been used, utilized for certain things. Right? For example, PANSS. So PANSS is a 30 item rating scale. Some of its rating scales items have been separately identified to measure the construct, different constructs. For example, delusions. So they come in few items, hallucinations, okay, aggression. So there are some items that have been separately studied. So if this has been studied, so you may be able to use that item separately. Or you can, this is also a very good thesis topic. For example, HAMD, you see whether the sleep is correlating with the good insomnia scale. Right. So these are practices that you can also do, but you can, in certain instances, use the scale. Okay. Second thing, HAMD, for example, it will vary with it just correlates with the severity of depression. In severe cases, if the HAMD rating is very high, the chances of the patient having depression increases. If it is very low, the chances decrease. But it is not a good score, a good scale to diagnose depression. Okay, but if you have diagnosed depression, it is okay. As a screening instrument, maybe you can use. Okay, you use a low HAMD scale and see that if this is less than 7, I will discard because chances of depression are less. But then whatever are screen positive, you have to clinically evaluate to rule out other. ऐसा तो नहीं कि साइकोसिस का पेशेंट भी आपका फॉल्स पॉजिटिव हो गया. सो इफ यू यूज द इंस्ट्रूमेंट यू शुड सी व्हाट इज द सेंसिटिविटी फॉर दैट स्पेसिफिक थिंग. फॉर एग्जांपल आप कह रहे हो कि मैं सिर्फ जो है यू आर डूइंग स्टडी फॉर इंसोम्निया एंड डिप्रेशन. ओके, हैमडी आपने लगाया उसमें इंसोम्निया देख लिया कि है कि नहीं. अगर इंसोम्निया उसमें जीरो है तो मैं एक्सक्लूड कर दूंगा. दैट इज गुड. because sensitivity is like specificity of that is zero. Kisi ko sleep problem hoi nahi hai, so it is highly unlikely ki usko rating scale mein bhi aayega. So that you can do. So you can use criteria sensitivity specificity for further evaluation, but you will need more than one rating scale. You can't just use the insomnia sirf HAM-D ke insomnia ko assess kar rahe, okay. Okay, this is Dr. Aditi said, how to maintain reliability. Okay, like she has done a scale, the rating is different. Somebody else has done a scale, the rating is different. So what are the reasons for change in reliability? One, she herself pointed out rapport with the patient. Okay, so one rater has a good rapport, the other has new. So one is resident in charge, the other has now today only taken up, does not know about the case. So the ratings are different. So how do we maintain a good reliability in a patient? What can we do? So that this does not differ. The rating scale to ek hi hai. Okay, so we need to understand what are the things that actually affect reliability. So time to interview. Somebody is taking 2 hours. Somebody is taking 15 minutes. So the rating will differ. So there are structured clinical interviews for that. Okay. Why are you, first of all, is why are you doing it? For example, if it is for, you are doing assessment for interview. So that affects the outcome, the treatment. Here, the more the extensive the interview, the better it is. All right. So as always, I said that detailed history, clinical interview, that is the gold standard. If you're using gold standard, then obviously it's the gold standard. But for research, if you're doing thesis patient, you're doing. So it is better to follow structured interview for HAM-D, for there is Sky PANS, structured clinical interview for PANS, structured interview for HAM-D. So what is a structured interview? First of all, structured interview is where you have to ask the question as they are written. You cannot change the language. It has to be read as it is. Okay. You can make the patient understand. So what happens is that there is standardization. So you will also be asking the same questions. All of you will be asking the same questions. Same questions and same time will be spent in rating the patient. So the reliability will be more. Okay. The variability among different will be not there. Number one. Number two, same person rates the patient. So in most of the studies in clinical trials, you'll find that the same rater who has rated the patient on the baseline will, at the end of the study, the same rater will see. So we want, here it is not difference between two patients, but we want to see what is the change in the patient at the start of the study and the end of the study. Okay, so we want the same rater to rate. So the change, if any, will be only because of the condition of the patient, not because of the change of the rater. Ek rater hai, wo hamesha high rating deta hai. Toh dono cases mein aise karega. Ek rater hai, wo low rating deta hai hamesha. Third is rated training. Okay. So most of the studies that is there, or instruments that are there, you need to train the raters. Okay. So there is a different level of eligibility. Some questionnaires anybody can apply. Nurse can apply, healthcare worker apply. Some questionnaires only medical persons can apply. Some questionnaires only trained clinicians can apply. For example, CGI. Okay. Global impression is only if you have a global impression. Okay. So that can only be done by a trained clinician. And some rating skill are there. Even the trained clinician has to undergo some further training. For example, WHO ke kuch scan or SA instruments that they were trained. People were trained to use that to diagnose the or use that instrument, because each instrument is different. It is not a clinical training, but it is basically to familiarize you with the rating scale, how rating scale will be used, what are the anchor points on which you will be scoring, so that each one of the people understands. And then what they do is they rate all the, I've undergone that rating many times. They will ask, they will show you a video of a patient. All of you will be asked to put rating, and then they will match it with their experts who have rated, 4 or 5 experts. So your rating should match. If it is statistically off, then they will find out where is the problem, and then they will train you further in that. And you will have to again undergo, say, test where you will rate a video until and unless you are, your rating is in at par with that of gold standards. Okay. So they rate for clinical trials, they are trained raters. Wonder Board is rating. So that is how you improve the reliability. Okay. Translation. Does translation affect the rating scale? Very good. Fir kya hoga usse? Construct badal jayega. Okay. Aapka man kaisa rehta hai? Kai log bolte hain sir, ulti si aa rahi hai. Matlab they understand nausea. Okay. So hai na? So jo hai jaise लखनऊ साइड में वो तो बोलते हैं जी कैसा रहता है पर यहाँ पे जी इज मोर लाइक नोजिया. ओके सो यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड डेफिनेटली लैंग्वेज डिफर्स. ओके सो इफ यू यूज इफ यू हैव टू ट्रांसलेट सो द ट्रांसलेटेड रेटिंग स्केल आल्सो हैज टू बी चेक्ड फॉर वैलिडिटी एंड कंसिस्टेंस रिलायबिलिटी. ओके सो आई मायसेल्फ हैव डन रिलायबिलिटी हैव डन दैट इन द पास्ट इंसोम्निया रेटिंग स्केल. So we translated, so there's a process for translation and then you test the reliability like you with the known instrument and see that. So what you want to see is Cronbach's alpha, jo internal consistency aur theek chal gaya, aapko koi criteria aisa to nahi hai ki wo galat translate ho gaya. Okay, aur aapko language expert bhi lene padte hain, but you can't structured clinical interview to nahi kar sakte aap translate kyunki wo the language will case. Okay, so translation affects, so you can't. Basically, so that is why when you are rating, if you have Hindi versions available, so that is good. But say even Hindi varies a lot. So if that is a point of your discussion, if you're writing thesis in discussion also you can write. But Hindi terminology also changes. जैसे यहाँ पे हम लोग बोलते हैं कि आप उदास रहते हो और जो है या खुश रहते हो तो ईस्टर्न यूपी में बोलते हैं कि आपका मन चटक रहता है फीका रहता है तो वो चटक और फीका इज व्हाट टर्मिनोलॉजी यूज. सो यू हैव टू फाइंड आउट कि वहां पर क्या वो यूज करते हैं टर्म्स. ठीक है तो खुश और उदास से यहाँ पे आई थिंक सो दैट पीपल अंडरस्टैंड बट पीपल हु आर बेसिकली फ्रॉम विलेजेस सो दे मे नॉट मतलब दे हैव यू हैव टू देन यू हैव टू असर्टेन टू व्हाट यू मीन बाय दैट. यू हैव टू फाइंड आउट दैट एक्चुअली जो आप कंस्ट्रक्ट आप असेस कर रहे हो वो भी वही उसी चीज की आंसर दे रहे हैं, वो कुछ और तो नहीं दे रहे. ठीक है सो दीज आर द बेसिक थिंग्स. इफ यू हैव एनी क्वेश्चंस रिलेटेड टू दिस ऑफ द रेटिंग स्केल्स क्वेश्चंस दैट यू हैव डिस्कशन व्हाट डू यू वांट टू आप लोगों को जेआर वंस को जो है करना पड़ेगा प्रोटोकॉल एक तीन महीने के अंदर तैयार. It is for you. Take help of your senior also. Okay. क्या कहते हैं तुम कौन से ratings के लिए use कर रहे हो अपने thesis में क्या क्या किया तुमने. Okay. So you have used two opioid and two insom. Okay. बोल रहे होगे पहले कि क्या डॉक्टर ध्यान नहीं देते एक ही कर नहीं देते बोलते हैं अच्छा तो यार हम भी कर रहे हैं यहाँ पे पीडीआई भी लगवा दिया मेरे को साथ. बट इफ यू यूज मोर देन वन इज लाइक इन दोनों में क्या है पिट्सबर्ग में और उसमें कौन सा बोल रहे दोनों सेल्फ सेल्फ रेटेड है पिट्सबर्ग इज सेल्फ रेटेड और दूसरा वाला असेसमेंट दिस इज डिफरेंस. ओके सो इफ यू आर यूजिंग देयर बेसिकली दिस आल्सो रेटिंग क्वेश्चनर्स में यू कैन यूज दिस इज द बेस्ट वन यूज सेल्फ रेटिंग सो उसमें आप बता दोगे वो पड़ेगा और दूसरा आप रेट करोगे. So we should conquer. BDI जैसे best depression inventory it is self-rated. So self-rated questionnaires and rater assessed questionnaires. Okay. So self-rated में इतनी there is not a question mark regarding the say eligibility of the rater. नहीं उसमें कुछ कि आपने MD नहीं करा आप कैसे कर सकते हो. People sometimes ask you can't do MD. You have not been rated for it. You have not been trained. Okay, so many times I've asked in the past also that you come do 2-3 like 5 patients rating and you documented that they were rated under the observation. Okay, and then it was validated ki haan aapki rating jo hai aap jo rate hai sahi kar rahe ho. दिस यू कैन डू यूज यूज अगर आपको मान लो कि आप केसेस कर रहे हो किसी में सिंपल यू 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 रेट 5 पेशेंट्स 10 पेशेंट्स अंडर द गाइडेंस ऑफ योर गाइड एंड रेटिंग और टू ऑफ यू रेट एंड यू से दैट दैट और दैट दिस वाज कंकरिंग तो आप अपने थीसिस में एक दो लाइन लिख दो बट इनिशियली 5 पेशेंट्स वर रेटेड एंड इट वाज असेस्ड दैट द रिलायबिलिटी ऑफ बोथ द रेटर्स वाज इक्वल ओके ये तुम लोग ट्रीटमेंट वो कर रहे हो एडवर्स इफेक्ट क्वेश्चनियर कर रहे हो उसमें तुम्हारा आईपीएमएस का ना चेकलिस्ट है वो चेकलिस्ट यूज कर सकते चेकलिस्ट इज आल्सो चेकलिस्ट में तो इतना वो नहीं होता पर जहां पे पैथोलॉजी यूज वो करनी है रेट करनी तो अगेन फॉर डायग्नोसिस इफ यू आर यूजिंग एन इंस्ट्रूमेंट सो वी नो दैट द गोल्ड स्टैंडर्ड इज क्लिनिकल सो यू कैन से दैट द डायग्नोसिस वाज से द गाइड और द क्लिनिशियन He concurred with the diagnosis. That one line is sufficient. Okay. और उसमें ऐसा कर सकते हो जैसे कि अगर मान लो कि तुम्हारे पास अगर तुमने 50 patients लिए कि two in that we excluded the two cases because the clinician thought that it was not a diagnosis. These are criteria. हम लोग criteria बोलते हैं. These are guidelines. But it can happen that I make a diagnosis of schizophrenia and it does not actually accurately concur with the DSM 5 criteria. There may be like ड्यूरेशन का क्राइटेरिया हो सकता है हम लोग तो अगर 3 वीक्स का भी 4 वीक्स का भी होगा तो यू कैन मेक अ डायग्नोसिस स्किज़ोफ्रेनिया है ना सो इन दैट थीसिस यू राइट दैट दिस वाज अ दैट इज व्हाई यू नीड अ गाइड ओके फॉर डायग्नोसिस इफ यू जस्ट ऐड दैट डायग्नोसिस में ऑल द डायग्नोसिस वर कंफर्म बाय द क्लिनिशियन दिस वन लाइन इज सफिशिएंट सो दैट एक्चुअली प्रूव्स द वैलिडिटी ऑफ योर केसेस जो आपने लिए हैं वो डिप्रेशन के केस हैं ऐसा नहीं कि आपने एमडी से स्क्रीन किया और सारे ले लिए और कहीं पे असेस नहीं किया Anything else? तुम्हारे क्या क्या रेटिंग स्केल हैं इसमें? चलो ठीक है बट दिस इज सीजीआई यू शुड गेट इट एक रेटिंग स्केल है माइल्ड मॉडरेट सिवियर जो भी यू गेट इट डन बाय योर गाइड और any faculty okay because that CGI has to be done by kya clinical global impression ab to khair tum logo ko bhi aa jayega clinical global impression you know what is it ha but hota kya hai clinical global impression mild moderate severe jaise aap log dekhte ho na ab to like you are in second year you would develop some You can say broad networks. You see a patient of mania. You see the history. You see the psychopathology. From your observation, where does that lie? Is he having mild symptomatology, moderate, severe, or very severe? वो कर सकते हो, तुम भी कर सकते हो. 3 years में तो definitely कर लो. Okay. So it is a मतलब broad network. It is not rating on something specific. पर वो तो हम ही कहते हैं कि ये सर ये better है, ये severe है, इसमें कोई improvement नहीं है. तो माइल्ड मॉडरेट सिवियर तो आप भी कर सकते हो विदाउट रेटिंग स्केल एक वाईएमआरएस लगाया वो अलग बात बट ऑन क्लिनिकल असेसमेंट ओनली बाय सीइंग हिज एजिटेशन स्लीप हाउ इज ऑन एमएससी सो मेनी टाइम्स आई से दैट ओके सर द पेशेंट इज इंप्रूविंग यू से नो सर ही स्टिल हैविंग ग्रैंडियोस टॉक्स ही स्टिल हैविंग बिग टॉक्स देयर इज नो इंप्रूवमेंट इन हैलुसिनेशंस देयर इज नो इंप्रूवमेंट इन इल्यूजन सो यू एज अ रेजिडेंट Have done an MSc and you find that okay, this cooperation is improved, sleep appetite is improved. He is now not creating ruckus, but the core pathology is still there. So based on that also, so you over the period of 3 years, you will be able to assess that where this patient lies: mild symptomatology, moderate, severe, very severe, and what is the level of improvement. So what you do is ki aap bhi mark kar lo aur sabse bhi mark kar lo ki concur karte hain karte hain. Usse tumhari bhi ek rating type ho jayegi. ठीक है सो दिस इज हाउ यू हैव टू एम्प्लॉय दिस एंड दिस विल हेल्प यू बिकॉज दीज आर द क्वेश्चंस दैट आर बेसिकली आस्क्ड इन थीसिस लाइक मेथोडोलॉजी ओके अदर प्रॉब्लम्स कैन बी यूजली करेक्टेड इफ देयर इज प्रॉब्लम इन मेथोडोलॉजी देन बिकम लाइक समबडी सेज दैट यू कांट यूज दिस इंस्ट्रूमेंट टू मेजर द कंस्ट्रक्ट दैट यू आर एक्चुअली ट्राइंग टू मेजर So then that would be a problem. You are trying to assess a construct. Okay, diagnosis कर रहे हो या आप severity कर रहे हो आपने उसके लिए ग्रेटिंग स्केल यूज किया वो कहेगा कि नहीं जो जो है ये आपने गलत तरीके से किया है, तो वो आपको फिर तो थीसिस दोबारा करनी पड़ेगी. दिस इज द थिंग दैट यू विल सी एज अ साइकियाट्रिस्ट. आई थिंक मेनी यू विल गेट स्टूडेंट्स ओके नॉट ओनली इन एमडी बट फार्माकोलॉजी ओके नर्सिंग ऑलराइट एंड देन साइकोलॉजी एंड देयर द ट्रेनिंग इन से एपिडेमियोलॉजी इज नॉट दैट ग्रेट सेंसिटिविटी स्पेसिफिसिटी सो दे हैव अ वेरी यू कैन से नॉट दैट ग्रेट you can understand so they can come up with methodology that is not right, right? So that's it. So okay, if you don't have any questions, बिल्कुल पूछो.
सर कोविड 19 में है बहुत सारा पब्लिकेशन हो चुकी है. एग्जांपल कोई स्टडी में सेमी स्ट्रक्चर इंटरव्यू स्केल नहीं मिल रहा है, सेमी स्ट्रक्चर इंटरव्यू है कोई स्केल नहीं है, अपने आप पे कुछ सेल्फ मेड क्वेश्चनर बना रहे हैं, एप्लीकेशन भी कर लिया, लेकिन उसके बाद वो क्वेश्चनर के कैसे स्केल बनाए?